because humanitarian aid destined for Gaza has been impounded by the Greek authorities. One of those ships is a Canadian ship. The efforts to provide this ship were entirely funded by Canadians through their contributions. The Canadian and United States governments have called this humanitarian aid and this flotilla of ships a provocation. In reality, it is nothing more than the efforts of citizens of various countries to break the illegal blockade. We are here today demanding that the Canadian government demand of Greece that it allow those ships to sail and provide the aid to the Gaza people.
Well, let's get into it a little bit. Why? Let's talk about the issue itself. Why is it important that boats be allowed to get?
We've been dealing. The people of Gaza have been suffering from an embargo against their country that has started up in about 2006, 2007. And got much worse, of course, after the massacre that took place in 2008, 2009. The consequence of that is approximately 1.5 million people are living in what amounts to an open-air prison. It is impossible for humanitarian aid and goods and services to flow freely between the outside world and Gaza, particularly coming in, flow fleeting into Gaza. The result is that the people of Gaza are suffering enormously from the effect of the Gaza war in 2008-2009. They have no ability to repair their houses and schools and to reconstruct their lives in a way that could even come close to being described as humanitarian and something that Canadians would respect.
What's happening to that aid? Why is it not getting to Gaza?
The Israelis have an embargo against Gaza. They're refusing to let anything in. Well, that's not true. They're letting in some goods, some humanitarian aid. They're saying that they're doing it because they want to prevent any kind of arms going into Gaza. The reality is that they're using the embargo to put enormous pressure upon the people of in Gaza to overthrow or to get rid of the Hamas government that is ruling there, a government that was elected by the people of Palestine back in 2006.
Now, we're a world away here in Winnipeg, and obviously you're with the Jewish Society, so why is this important for you to organize something here in Winnipeg?
I think the major thing that matters to us is that it's a matter of dignity and respect. We think that the issue there is a serious blight on the world in terms of what the humanitarian situation is. These boats, these Freedom Flotillas, should be allowed to move into Gaza and to deliver their aid, in some cases, like the American boat, simply to deliver letters from the people of the United States showing their solidarity and concern with the suffering of the people of Gaza. A boat carrying thousands and thousands of letters from the United States is being prevented by the Greek authorities from being able to leave their ports, and we know perfectly well that the Israelis will seize that ship and others on its journey into Gaza in the name of protecting Israeli security. We're concerned about all people's security in the region. We're concerned about all people's well-being in the region. The Israelis' security, the Palestinian security, Israeli well-being, Palestinians' well-being. Not just one group's well-being and security, all humanity's well-being and security in the area.
What are you guys hoping to accomplish today by doing this here in town?
We hope that we can put some pressure on the Canadian government to support the Freedom Flotilla, to also encourage Canadians to support the Freedom Flotilla, to give them proper information about what is actually going on there right now. Current situation is that Greece is being pressured, we believe, by Israel and the United States to stop the boats in Greece so that Israel will not have to intercept the boats on the high seas as it did last year when it intercepted the Freedom Flotilla I and resulted in the Israelis killing nine of the Freedom passengers on board.
Thanks, Howard.
You're welcome.